Hey guys, what's up? It's a King here. Today, I'm doing an official reaction of the Grand Theft Auto 6 trailer. This is finally here. It was actually a day early. It's supposed to be released tomorrow morning at 9 a.m., but I guess leakers got a hold of it, and Rockstar decided to release it now, which is pretty cool because I can react to it for you guys now. I know I've been gone for the past like 6, 7, 8 months. I'm not really sure how long it's been, but a channel update probably in the next few days will be released telling you guys what the future plan is for this. But anyways, right now I just want to come back to review, watch and break down this trailer with you guys. So anyways, let's get started. Before I get started, I want you guys to hit the subscribe button, hit that like button, hit the post notification button so you guys will be notified whenever I upload a video. Said that a little too fast. And hit that share button to share this video with all your friends. You guys enjoy this video in the future. Anyways, let's get right into it. Here we go.
Lucia, do you know why you're here?
Bad luck, I guess.
It's really good so far. Very sexualized. Vice City's back, baby. That's cool. I wonder how this is gonna be introduced within the game itself.
Well, look who's back.
The only way we're gonna get through this is by sticking together. Being a team. Trust?
Trust.
And that's it. Alright, and that's it. So, this looks really cool. Now I'm going to kind of break it down for you guys, from kind of still by still. So we're going to go to the beginning, right here. Now I'm not really sure what this is supposed to be. All the way, I'm not really sure where it is because the map hasn't been released yet. And I'm not really sure what it looks like. I'm sorry, disclaimer, my chair is creaky. You guys are probably going to hear that a little bit while I talk, just letting you guys know. But anyways, so if you kind of look at it, there's a prison right here. And obviously, in the next shot, I think her name is what? Lucia, I think? I'm not really sure what her name is. Looks like she's in prison. How she got in prison, I'm not really sure how. Then right here shows off the beach. I guess you can call this Vice Beach. Obviously, this is in Miami. Vice City. Vice City is back, guys. This is awesome. Vice City hasn't been really talked about. Not talked about, but like it hasn't been in a GTA since, man, I think Vice City Stories, and that was all the way back in 2006. And by the time this releases, if it's released in 2025, it'll be 19 years since Vice City has been touched on by a video game by GTA, because like I said, Vice City Stories was released in 2006. And this isn't going to be released until 2025. So that's 19 years away from Vice City. It's nice to be back. Rockstar Games Presents. Building right there. I'm not sure what this is supposed to... I mean, it's a building, obviously. It's going to be a little city part to Vice City. Looks really good so far. Here we go. Next still. This is a fan boat. Now, I'm not really sure what... this is supposed to be, I mean, obviously a fan boat, but I guess this is just something that's used in the swamp area. Here's some more wildlife. I think pelican, Tony Montana's favorite animal. No, that's tiger. But here's some pelicans. Lots of wildlife going on. This definitely reminds me of Red Dead Redemption 2. Speaking of wildlife, I guess you can call this wildlife, but lots of stuff going on here. There are I'm sorry if I sound trembling, but this is a lot to take in. I mean, GTA 6, guys, like, this is the first time this is, like, ever been fully released by Rockstar. I mean, yeah, we had the leaks last year, but this is, like, something that's released officially by Rockstar. We're seeing this with our eyes, and it's amazing. It's really cool. But anyways, this is, I'm guessing you can call it Vice Beach. Oh, wow, goes all the way down. So much stuff going on here. We got, you know, we got little dogs, people laying on the sand. We got this going on over here. We got some jet skis over here, people on the water. A lot of stuff going on. I can't say this stuff really went on in GTA 5 itself, just because, even the beaches weren't really that full in GTA 5. Now, obviously, you know, there's limitations and all that stuff. But still, I mean, it's pretty cool. Next, we got this by the... I'm not sure what this is, but I definitely recognize it. If you've seen the TV show Dexter, now this might not be the same spot, but it looks like the area where in the first episode he rides his boat out. It's by this this cargo freighter. I'm sorry if I'm saying it wrong, but he drives his boat by this, and that's pretty cool. It just reminded me a lot of that shot. We got some people driving boats around, the cities behind them, bridges. Also, we got another port area. Hopefully, we can do something with this port here. I'll get more on, like, what we're able to do in a future video. Like, kind of like my wishes of what wishes and won't, what I want to be in GTA 6 and what I don't want to be want in GTA 6. Next, we got this going on. Looks like a street race. This guy looks like he's taking a picture or something. I'm not sure. I think this is Lucia, I think. I really don't know. I'm sorry. But it looks like they're driving away or racing or something like that. The mileage is like, what, 70, I think? I don't know. But if you look in the background, there's a lot of neon shots going on. A lot of stuff going on over here. Yeah. Next shot we got going on is this is, my guessing, is like more like the gang type territory. I'm not really sure what you'd call this, but it's definitely not the high life of Vice City, but it's not like the low life of Vice City, if you know what I mean. It's definitely in it's kind of up there. I'm trying not to jump over my words here, but this looks pretty good. I'm not really sure what exactly is going on here, but there's definitely a lot going on here. Not really much I can explain at the moment, you know. Next, we got the club going on, and one thing, like I said before, this game is very sexualized. They put a lot of work into this. I mean, you got this stuff going on over here, and obviously, it's a club, strip club type thing. I mean, obviously, it's going to be sexualized 100%, but I'm just saying there's a lot of that. This, I'm not really sure what's going on here. These are definitely some type of members of a gang or something. Maybe the Haitian gang makes a return from Vice City. Who knows? Definitely these two, or this guy seems like he's definitely a big character in the game, or a decent character who's going to make some type of impact to the game. This guy reminds me of just some generic goon that's like, oh, he's right there, boom. You know what I mean? It's like there's some generic NPC that's like, yep, I'm here. Kind of like in GTA San Andreas when you're walking and people are going behind them. Those like the gang members behind him building up. This is what I'm getting from this. Maybe this guy's a big kid. Sorry. Maybe he's a big person in the game, but from what I see, he doesn't really play a huge part from what I see. A lot going on here. We got the neon stuff going on again. I'm sorry. You don't know under the weather right now, but anyways. We got some Vice City S cars. It looks like, I'm not really sure what, a cheetah? I think you call that a cheetah. Sorry. looks like we got some beggars going on here. Got some women over here. We got some people in the streets. Definitely seems a lot more populated than GTA 5, but then again, this is a trailer, so I'm not really sure how populated this might be. But it definitely seems a lot more populated than GTA 5 did. Now, again, GTA 5 came out in a completely different age of video games, where obviously GTA 5 at the time wasn't really, it was major, but like not like Red Dead 2 major, if you know what I mean, when it came to like RPG elements and gameplay type stuff. Moving on from this, we got some clubs. Not really much going on here. I'm not really sure. Actually, I was looking forward to talking about this. A lot going on here. We got some planes. Looks like a yacht down there that might be moving. We got some cargo ships moving over here. Other islands. I think there's definitely going to be some more islands. And I'll talk about this more in my game, in my GTA 6 wish list video. I am really hoping that we get more than one. Like, more than, like, two small towns, or three small towns. Because in GTA 5, we didn't really have much to go with in that game. Now, what I mean is, like, if you look at a game like GTA San Andreas, GTA Vice City, GTA 4, these games felt a lot more bigger, a lot more livelier, because there was so much going on in every single town that was going on. Now, obviously, San Andreas is, like, 5, where, now, my biggest gripe about 5 is that there's so much mountain. You know, you have a Los Santos Mountain, Sandy Shores. Big mountain, Pulido Bay. Then you have a mountain over here, mountain over here. I don't like that. That just takes up too much space for nothing. For nothing. When you can fill up, when you can fill that spot with something that's meaningful. Now, I'm hoping we get at least more than two or three towns. I'm really hoping we get some big, like a big city, Vice City. Then a little town, big town. You know, just kind of vary it. I'm really hoping we get something like that. This definitely shows promise that we might be getting something like that. This looks like an unconstructed, under construction bridge. I'm not really sure what that would be there for. Maybe a stunt jump. I don't know. I got that from the professional. He brought that up. I didn't watch this before. This actually came out while I was elsewhere, not here. So I watched videos before, but I watched a video from the professional. Check him out. Really good YouTuber. He did mention right here could be a stunt jump, so that's definitely a good possibility of something like that happening. Then we got this going on here, like I said, very sexualized. They did put a lot of time into doing that. I do find that pretty funny. But obviously right here, just to kind of let you know, like, hey, we're in Vice City now. This is it, you know? I really do like that touch. Then we got some social media aspects. We got a little party here. Not really sure what's going on here. Got some alligators in pools. I'm really hoping homes are a lot more vibrant than they were in GTA 5. Because GTA 5, the homes felt very stale. I mean, buildings in general felt very stale. And like I said, I'm going to talk about this in another video. But I'm really hoping we get more RPG elements in GTA 6. Like I said, more sexualization of stuff. Then right here we got some, you know, night meat, racing type meat, something like that. I'm not really sure. I'm hoping this is something that we can see a lot in the game, but who knows? Then we got some more stuff going on here. I think they're gonna take a lot from the social media aspect of now. Like the phones in GTA 6 are gonna be a lot more bigger than they were in GTA 5, because GTA 5, I mean, like you're pretty much on like an iPhone 4. iPhone 3, you know, the biggest iPhone at that time, versus now you got like basically tablets in your pockets, big computers in your pockets. So I do feel like they're going to take a lot from social media nowadays, and they're going to poke fun at it, which I really hope Rockstar doesn't lose that and they start poking fun at, you know, us as a community, you know, poke fun at all of the different communities, because that's what Rockstar is for. Piss everyone off. That's what they really need to start doing. Just piss everybody off. That's what Rockstar lives for, and that's what they need to do. Anyways, we got an alligator coming into a store. That's pretty cool. Now, this kind of brings up my point from earlier, that I really hope that businesses, a lot more businesses in GTA 5, are accessible, like a lot more. Like, I'm talking not just like two or three. I mean, like a ton. I mean, this game has been worked on for about 10 years now, as far as I know. And by the time it releases, 12 years. There, we better have a lot of accessible interiors. Next up to this is a police cam. Now, I don't know how this would be integrated into the story. I'm not really sure how. Now, obviously, there's going to be more trailers and more stuff to kind of lead towards what we get. But for now, I'm not really sure what this is, why this is here. Maybe, you know, the big phenomenon of body cams nowadays. Body cams play a big part in, you know, policing and just communities in general, especially what went on in the past, like, 5 years, body cams play a huge part in police activity, stuff like that. So I can definitely see something along those lines happening within this clip or whatever. Next, obviously, we got some more social media type stuff. Not really much going on here. Oh, missed one. Yep, more stuff here, more stuff here. Got some, go back. Got some crazy stuff going on here. This looks like some type of meet. Now, in GTA 5, remember, you can go, like, off-road racing. I feel like this might be something a part of that. I'm not sure what, but it does look very interesting because, I mean, obviously, mudding is a big part of, I guess you can call it the redneck community. I'm not really sure what you'd call it, but these people look like, you know, rednecks. I mean, look at the trucks, four of that stuff, and they're covered in mud. I do. This does look pretty cool. I ain't gonna lie. It does look cool. And I'm hoping mud looks realistic instead of just like, oh, you drive through sandy shores in GTA 5 and, oh, we got mud on, like, you know, like a splash of mud here. I'm hoping it just gets all over your vehicle, and I hope it does that. It should. Here we got some more, you know, social media stuff. Then we got this. I'm not really sure what to make of this. It's a party, I guess. I think this is Jason. This looks pretty cool. I guess them holding money, they just robbed some place. Now obviously when the leaks came out, I'm sorry, I'm saying a lot, but when the leaks came out, there was a lot of speculation that these two were a couple. Now, this trailer definitely made it known that these two are a couple and that they're going to be like a Bonnie and Clyde type thing. And I'm looking forward to see how that arises. I'm really hoping this story stays very grounded, and I'm hoping that these two don't get in the way of a good story, if you know what I mean. Like you have a couple, and don't, what I mean is, like, don't put these couples' relationship affairs in front of everything. Keep it at a minimum. Have them have problems. Have them be very realistic. But keep the story grounded. That's my biggest wish of GTA 6. Keep the story grounded, but then make it fun. You know what I mean? Don't go Saints Row level of not grounded, because obviously they're not. It's not going to be that great. It's going to be wild. But this is Rockstar Games we're talking about. They're very good at keeping their games grounded. Next, we got some Weasel News coverage. Weasel News, like, is making a return. No overturning zone. Copper S man who flipped his car after Pee-wee's Dine and Dash. Not really sure what to make out of that. Maybe it's something that has to do with the story. Then we got this. I'm not really sure what this is. Maybe it's people you can recruit. I really don't know. Now, you were in prison at the beginning of this trailer, so I don't know what this really is. We'll have to just wait and see about that. We got some dirt bikes going on here. I'm kind of skipping. Oh, wait. Dirt bike, dirt bags. Vice City. Obviously, Vice City's coming back, guys. Woo! You know? I do see a lot of RPG elements coming to this game. I really do. This is Instagram. I do, because, yeah, Instagram, YouTube, TikTok, they're all going to be parodied. They're all going to be, you know, something big into this game, because let's be real. TikTok, Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, those took the world by storm. And there's no way they're not going to be GTA 6. No way. But this looks like something that this guy is, you know, he's hosting. Maybe he'll play a decent part in the game. Who knows? Here is Jason and Lucia robbing what looks to be a gas station. Here's them getting away. Again, not really sure what to make of that. I don't know. And, okay, good shot. Here's a shot of them as, like, a couple. They're like, oh, you know, you guys saw the trailer. But, yeah, this is pretty interesting. Definitely a Bonnie and Clyde type thing going on. And I'm very excited to see what happens. And I really hope this game is good. And that is the trailer breakdown and the trailer watch. I hope you guys enjoyed that video. I'm back. I'm ready to make some more videos. Give me some suggestions in the comments to tell you guys what you want to see. I'm definitely going to be talking about GTA 6 for the near future. Channel update is coming in the next few days. I really want to talk about where the channel is going to be going from here on out, because I want to get back into it. I really want to start making videos again, and hopefully this is the start of a decent channel base. I don't know. So guys, before I leave, I want you guys to hit the subscribe button, hit that like button, hit that post notification button so you guys may notified whenever I upload a video, and hit that share button to share this video, all your friends so you guys know this will be more future. And anyways, I will see you guys in the next one. Take care now. Bye.